In this video, we're going to take an in-depth look at how to complete the survey portion of your project. So you're going to be in your Google Drive. You'll access your Google Drive here and by clicking Drive. Once you're in the Drive, you're going to go to New, then More, then you're going to select Google Forms. Now, why do we want to use Google Forms? Google Forms is free, so there's no cost to you as a student, and it's really great about organizing the responses in a way that you can copy and paste or quickly type those in. You're going to want to title your form for your survey. So let's say if I'm surveying average commute time. So that'll be the title of my survey. You do not want to enter any personally recognizing information. So don't ask them for an email address. Don't ask for them for their name. You want to launch your first question should be the most important. You should not be utilizing multiple choices because you cannot work with multiple choice data. You need to actually have them enter the number or the value. So in order to do that, you're going to do short answer. Once you're in short answer, you could say, what is your average commute to work one way? And so that's going to allow them to answer. So they'll see this question, then they'll be able to enter their answer. To add another question, because you need to have about a total of 3 questions, because you need to do 8 calculations and the final submission of the project. And there's not enough stuff that we can do with the 1 claim question. So after your claim question, I've given you some follow-up questions to give a lot of you as we discuss different things. So you're going to go back in, you're going to choose short answer, and maybe one of the ones I suggested was gender. Now, technically, you could probably do gender as a multiple choice. So you could do it that way. You're just going to have a little bit of trouble with the data, but you could do male and female here if you want to avoid kind of getting a lot of the different choices or pronouns, or if you want to add the, you know, different other gender classifications, you could do multiple choice there as well. So that's your second question. So you're going to click add to get your third one. And depending on what you've done, you might want to ask age. I've made a suggestion to you in your claim. So then you can enter short answer and it gives you age. So you have 3 questions. Once you have your 3 questions, I like to preview it just to see what it's going to look like. So this is what it's going to look like to your participant. It's not asking them to identify anything about themselves. So that will kind of get past that roadblock. And then once you've done that, you can do a couple of different things. You can get a pre-filled link. This is what I suggest that you do, is you get a pre-filled link and then see at the bottom it says get link. And it's going to copy that link to your clipboard. Or you can come up here and you can select Control C so that then you can take your Facebook and you can actually paste the link for this into Facebook so that they'll click the link and it will drive them to your survey automatically. Okay. So that's kind of the idea here with getting into this actual form, is getting the pre-filled link. There's some settings you can adjust. I don't suggest doing collect email settings. It might be good to limit it to 1 response because that way people are sure if they did or they didn't complete it. You don't get duplicates. So when they submit twice, it won't actually show up. So this is the way I suggest you doing this. Once you have your Google Forms filled out, you'll click the responses tab and it's going to give you all the responses here in an organized manner. Another thing to check is to make sure that when you're in responses that you have this toggle. See how this big red thing comes across? You want to make sure that this is on so you get accepting responses. So make sure that you're double checking that as you just kind of click before you send your link out. Once you have that link, you can post it on any social media website. You can email the link out. You could even text the link to people to fill out, because remember, you need 100 people to answer this survey. So you want to get your survey out as soon as possible and make sure that your claim is approved as soon as possible.